Okay, so we have started the Phaeophyta. I think we have seen the some photographs, genera present in the Phaeophyta: Ectocarpus, Sargassum, Spacellaria, then Crustacea, right? Then giant kelp. It is the Nerocystis. Then Laminaria is there on right hand side. You see the Laminaria. So yesterday in the first lecture we have seen about the details. Then nextly the Phaeophyta, brown algae, their habitats, and the larger thallus we have seen. This is the Nerocystis, and it shows generally, as you are observing, this person, he is handling this material, and generally all members are having about the marine water. The as it is the largest group in the algae, about 240 genera and 1500 species we have seen. Yeah, out of these 32 genera and 93 species occurring in the Indian Oceanic part, that is the Indian Ocean, Bay of Bengal, and the there is having the Arabian Sea is there. So our Maharashtra coastal area, it is also showing the Sargassum and the other forms are there. Then in general characteristics we have seen some important thallus like this one, as there are the specifically the sea palms are there. So genera like the Nerocystis or the Laminaria, the D diagram. C is, it is the Postelsia palmiformis. It is commonly called as the sea palm. You are observing, this looks like the sea palm. Then there is a Macrocystis and Nerocystis are there. This is the Macrocystis and the Nerocystis. A and the B diagram photographs are there. Then Ralphsia is the one genus. Generally it is showing the like the fungus mushroom type occurrence is there. Then in morphological character, there are the air bladders are present, particularly in the these kelps are there, hold fast stipe and the bladder, hold fast generally attached to the rocky area. And many important character already we have seen. These forms are attached to the rocks, so they are called as a benthic condition. Commonly pigments are in the form of the chromatophores. There are no chloroplast. In some orders only chloroplast is present. Maximum they are showing the chromatophores are there. Then in relation to the other characteristics, we have seen the photosynthetic pigments, generally chlorophyll E, chlorophyll C, xanthophylls, then xanthophylls of lutein, picoxanthin, flavoxanthin, these are the common. So you remember the highlighting characters. Pyrenoids are present, but if present they are single stalk type, and usually these are the absent. So pyrenoid is present in the chloroplast. Then reserve food is in the form of the laminarin and mannitol sucrose, and the sucrose and the glycerol are also present. So Japan like countries, they have in the certain sea industries are there. They produce their food particularly under these marine brown algae. Then there are the special some reproduction character, vegetative, asexual and sexual. So in vegetative, by fragmentation, the special reproductive branches or the propagules, they develop the new plant. Good example in the order Spacellaria. Then asexual, by means of zoospores. Generally zoospores develops in unilocular sporangia and the plurilocular sporangia. We are observing in Ectocarpus. Then sexual reproduction is isogamous in Spacellaria, oogamous in Fucales, Dictyotales and the Laminarials. So we are observing these three genera, Fucus, Dictyota and the Laminaria, in the life cycle, right? So you, again I am repeating this because it is the very large and interesting. Then class in life cycle pattern, these for two life cycle, diplontic life cycle and diplohaplontic life cycle. Diplontic seen in sargassum, and in diplohaplontic ectocarpus and laminaria shows isomorphic. Iso means same, morphic means morpho, and heteromorphic, this two thalluses are different, here is seen in the laminaria. So classification system according to Fritsch in 1935. So they divided into 9 orders are there as per genera: ectocarpus, teleopteris, cutlaria, sporomucus, then desmarcia, laminaria, specialaria, dictyota and the sargassum. So sargassum order is the fucals, because the other fucus is the main genera. Then you see the economic importance for the manufacture of the presence of due to the phycocolloids like algin and the picoidine are there, secondary metabolites, so used in the manufacture of beer, toothpaste, or the creams are there, shaving creams are there, or the medicines and the soap preparation is there. So maximum members they are used abundant. Then we have started work for the different order as per the characters, as per the order. So characters are, you have to report about the vegetative. Then in ectocarpus it is filamentous, heterotrichous, then pseudoparenchymatous. There is no true parenchyma, but it looks like the parenchyma, so termed as a pseudoparenchyma. Then all about the here the chloroplast are present. Each cell contains the chloroplast, see the point number 4, with the single pyrenoid is present. Then reproduction takes place asexually, zoospores in plurilocular sporangia, and the sexual by isogamy and the anisogamy. So family ectocarpus, genus ectocarpus. Same thing fucus, the fucus genera and the sargassum, two genera, family sargassaceae is the seen. So here the alternation of generation we are observing. Then we have seen about the order laminarials, genus is the laminaria. So just you note down the you have to remember this character. Then in this laminarials, family laminariaceae. So generally plant body is the sporophytic. So it shows the hold pass type and the leaf blades are there, right? So here the sporangia developing in the distinct groups on both surface of the leaf blade. Then these are the photographs of these all genera. So you just observe it. So thallus of the different forms are there. So generally there are the alginic acid and this one, they occurring in the laminaria. Then in general mode of nutrition, fucoxanthin is the main pigment is there, and the locomotion is there, right? Then you are observing this is sargassum. So the sea, as you photo, you see the photograph, it is called as the sargasso sea, right? So sargassum is the dominant in this one. As the there is the main characteristics, the sargassum, it shows air bladders and this one. Then important how to remember the life cycle. So laminaria shows the sporophytic plant body is diploid, it develop anthidia and the oogonia. So here the meiosis takes place, in asexual zoospores develop, then these germinate and forms a thallus, one from a male gametophyte, female gametophyte, sperm and the egg develop, and the after fusion fertilization it shows the zygote, directly zygote germinate and forms the sporophyte, right? So this is the character. In life cycle stages you see the diagrammatic about the ectocarpus is there. So ectocarpus, as you observe the nature, the receptacles are there, already we are knowing in the sargassum, like in the this conceptacles are there, so male conceptacle and the female conceptacle. So as there are the Antheridia and the Oogonia are there, so they later on Antheridia develop the sperm and Oogonia develop the egg. Fertilization takes place. There is a zygote and it gives the thallus. Right. This is the good photo group of the Laminaria, and it shows the there is having the hold past and the formation of the sea palm is there, right? So sea palm is the character. Just you see how the economy is this. Just we have discussed above in Japan, there are the secondary products are present, so it is used as food, and due to the alginate content, commonly these are separated, collected from the ocean, and it is separated and used as a food. So this is the character. Here you are observing the some species in the Phaeophyta. So Phaeophyta orders are there: Desmariales, Dictyotales, Laminariales, Fucales, Sporophyales, right? So how their linkage is there? So basically it starts from the Phaeacoidea and the Cyclosporidae, subfamilies are there. Then Padaena genus, you are observing this left hand side, lower photo of green, Padaena genus. Then Laminaria, then it shows the Ectocarpus and the other genera are there. Then Fucus looks like this one in natural condition. Then Hydro Calathus is there. So just I am repeating because as it is not understanding in the one lecture, so you have to go for this one. So Dictyota, you observe this thallus, Dictyota. These are the some specimens from outside. The scales are there. Here you are observing the centimeter scale, so it is only 4 centimeter thallus, but shows the detail development or the structure is there. Now this genus Ectocarpus, it reproduces asexually, sexually, and it developed the sporangium. So unilocular and plurilocular sporangia are there. So unilocular sporangia, you observe here how the development is there in the Ectocarpus genus. So this shows the zoospores, smaller are the meiozoospores. They are developing, which are the haploid in the nature, and there is the germination of meiozoospores. It gives to the formation of the male gametophytes or the sexual plants in the life cycle. Right. Then plurilocular sporangia, it shows the multicellular body, and it having the this character. Development of these zoospores are there. It takes place in the gametangia, isogamous condition. So anisogamous types, they are of two types. The plurilocular it develops, and some are the small, some are the larger, and there is a formation, they develop the elongated structures are there. You are observing here these conditions of the gametangia are there. Then in fertilization and germination, the brown algae, generally they are in the groups and therefore in the some unicellular forms. So plasmogamy is there, and they develop the gametes and forms the zygote formation is there. So zygote undergoes germination, reduction, division, diploid sporophyte develop the unilocular, plurilocular sporangia on the same plant. So these are the some changes already we have seen the life cycle pattern. Then structures of gametophyte, it is very typical. The chromatophores are there present in this one, and the cell wall is generally having the tight, very tight, and it shows the female gamete and the male gamete, these are developing the same. Then in life cycle pattern, Ectocarpus, as you are observing here, this is the it shows the asexual reproduction and the sexual reproduction. So the thallus are different, unilocular and plurilocular, both are developing here, and there is a zygote formation. Again it shows the diploid thallus formation is there. So all about this, again Pheophyta, as yesterday we have seen, but I think there may be some points are remained, so therefore I have repeated here again. Okay, so thanks to all. In the next lecture we will see about the last our syllabus point about the Rhodophyta.